One of the best ways to get a softer hand feel with your DTF transfers is to have some open space in the design where the shirt's color can show through. This is called a color knockout. Now, many rip softwares have a color knockout tool, but I like to use the graphic design program as the results are a lot more controllable. Hi, I'm Jeremy with DTF Superstore, and in this tutorial, we're going to use Adobe Illustrator, though this can be accomplished in CorelDRAW and GIMP. Let's open Illustrator.
Now looking at this graphic here, we've got this red dragon. Ultimately, probably is gonna look best on a black t-shirt, which is why we've got this black background here, just so we can compare and make sure that our knockout doesn't screw up the image too much. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go to layers here, and we're gonna hide this back layer. And now let's take a look at it here. To select just the black colors that are in this, we're gonna use shortcut A, which is your direct select tool. And we're gonna click on the black. Not very complicated yet, except however you can see there's some spots here that aren't selected. To make sure we select all of one specific color, in this case black, we're gonna go up to select same fill color. And that's gonna select everything that's got this same fill color on it. Now to get rid of it, you could just hit delete, but that is going to damage the original file. We just want to tweak it a little bit. So we're gonna click the appearance area here with the fill color, and we're gonna make no fill, which is the box with the little red line through it. That's a no fill. And now this is kind of what your graphic looks like. If you want to verify that you didn't screw something up, click on the background, which is gonna simulate our black shirt color. And there we go. Perfect example of a nice color knockout. The beauty of the color knockout is, one, it's gonna give the shirt a lot softer hand feel, and two, it's gonna save you ink costs because you're printing a lot less ink when you do a color knockout. And here's an example of this exact graphic on a shirt, and I will tell you, it feels so much softer than if we didn't knock out that black color. Now let's say your customer comes to you with this graphic and they say they want it on a red shirt. First things first, that's gonna be great because you'll be able to get rid of this kind of sun behind it and let that be the color of the shirt showing through. But one of the problems is if you did a red shirt, it's not gonna look right. So whenever you are trying to do a color knockout with a color that is on the graphic right at the edge of where the image ends or where the shirt would start, you need some kind of border around it. So in our case, in this, we're gonna put a border around the outside of this sun and around these red Chinese graphics here. So like before, with the A tool selected, we're gonna click on the sun, but we're not gonna do the same fill color yet. We're going to create a stroke around this. So right here, we click on stroke in the appearance panel and we select black, and then we're gonna start to increase the stroke. And as we increase that, you may notice it changes here. I'm gonna zoom in a little bit so you can see easier. Notice how it's creating a stroke on either side of the line. That's fine for the outside, except what's happening is we're actually creating a wider stroke here in the middle. See how that's looking wider? That's not quite what we want. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna realign our stroke to be on the outside, and you're gonna see that's gonna kind of hide it behind the dragon. So if you click on the word stroke, right now we're aligned to the center of the stroke. You could align it to the inside, but we wanna align it to the outside, and watch what happens. Now we kind of almost make that stroke disappear behind the dragon. Now this is a little bit wide for me. I want it to be about the same width. So I'm gonna select it again. I'm gonna bring my width down till it's about the same width as the dragon's outline. Yeah, I like the way that looks. And then real quick, let's do these Chinese characters here. Again, A tool selected. There's a little corner of a letter here. Same thing as before, we're gonna do our stroke. We do want it to be black, yes. And this obviously we're not gonna do as thick because the letters aren't as big. I think 10 looks pretty good. Yeah. And then let's click this one over here. Add our stroke that is black. And we're gonna do 10 like the other side. Here we go. Now, when we do bring our background color or our shirt color back, okay, we can still see it well. I purposely picked a different red for the background than is red in the graphic, just so it's a little easier for you guys to see. But then using the A tool, we're gonna select this red. We're gonna go to select, same fill color. That's gonna select everything that is this red color, which includes this Chinese graphics and other areas. See how the stroke here has question marks? This means we have different strokes on some of the graphics, but we're gonna click on the fill color. We're gonna do no fill. And there we go. Now you notice it didn't get rid of all the red because some of the red in here is different colors than that main red was. So if you want to get rid of more of the red, this may be that slightly different color. Click here on these areas, just select a red somewhere. Select same fill color, select a few more of those red areas and go with no fill here. And when we drop that background layer in, you'll see our image still looks true to the original, but in this case, look at all that ink we knocked out. And again, it's gonna make this shirt feel softer. And as a DTF producer, you're gonna use less ink. This is awesome. Now, not every graphic file you get is going to be ideal for color knockout like this. Let me show you an example. If I tried to use the same techniques we used before, with the A tool selected or direct select tool selected, I click on the tan here, because in my brain, I'm gonna put this on a tan shirt. I think it'll look really killer. Go to select, same fill colors, and we're gonna go to the no fill. Oh no, that did not look so good. So how do we fix that? Let me show you. I'm gonna select everything. And this only works if there's no stroke. You can see here, we don't have a stroke. If we did have any strokes here, we would first need to go to Object, Path, Outline Strokes. You would do that first. So you wanna make sure that there's no stroke. Even if you see question marks here, that means there's different strokes. You just want no strokes. Now we're gonna go to Object, Expand, and then we're gonna go open up your Pathfinder window. So go to Windows, Pathfinder, and we're gonna select the merge here under Pathfinders. And what this is basically doing is taking all the layers on top of each other and it's kind of cookie cuttering them out of each other. So now when we go back to do what we did before, select the tan color, select same fill color, and we go to no fill, works perfectly. Now, if we want to verify what we've done has worked properly, just make a little square rectangle behind it. We're going to select a color for it, maybe a nice kind of sandy tan color, and we're going to right click, arrange, send it back. Perfect. Again, color knockouts are great to soften the hand feel of the shirt. And as a DTF producer, you're gonna use less ink, saving you money and having happier customers. It's really a win-win.